Hi guys, CodeTutor here and my name is Anil Deshpande.
In the previous video, you just got introduced to the concept of shared preferences. In this video, we will explore it a little bit further. Let us have a look at the setting screens of some of the Android apps that we typically come across. If you observe, you will realize that the setting screens of all Android apps have similar look and feel. And when you start developing your own apps, it is actually recommended that you also make sure that the design of the setting screen is consistent with the Android's settings screen. The usage of settings screen is such a common feature in Android apps that Android provides you a ready-to-use activity called as Preference Activity. The Preference Activity is actually backed up by the shared preferences. So whatever the settings that you maintain in this particular screen are actually stored in the shared preferences. Now the obvious question that you might be having is, how can I access the shared preferences that are stored by the settings screen? How can I read the values that are there in that particular shared preferences? And what if I want to be notified when any value changes in the shared preferences? For this, there is another API called as Preference Manager. The Preference Manager comes up with then method called as get default shared preferences, which always returns you the shared preferences that are being maintained for the settings screen of the app. Once you get hold of the shared preferences, it is pretty easy to access anything that is there in that particular shared preference and read anything that is there in the shared preference. Coming to the third point, assume that you have a timer wherein as soon as there is no activity in the application or there is no user interaction with the application for say around 2-3 minutes, you want to automatically log out of the application. The settings of whether you have to log out after 2 minutes, 3 minutes or 10 minutes is being maintained in the shared preference. So as soon as you modify the value in the shared preference, you want to reset the timer and start again. Basically, you want to have some kind of a listener that gets triggered as soon as values change in the shared preference. And that is where another API called as OnSharedPreferenceChangeListener comes into picture. To register and unregister this listener, you can use a shared preference API. The method registerOnSharedPreferenceChangeListener can be used to register the listener, and unregisterOnSharedPreferenceChangeListener can be used to unregister the listener. I think it is now better to get into a quick demo and have a look at the code on how it is done. In the demo, I will be reusing the file IO demo code that I have been using since the beginning. Now the only difference is I will be adding a menu item called as settings, and when I click on this particular settings, a new activity called as settings activity will be triggered. We will first begin by creating another activity called as settings activity. If you observe, this particular settings activity extends preference activity. Preference activity is subclass of an activity. Only the difference is inside the onCreate method, instead of calling set content to set the XML UI, you invoke another method called as add preference from resource, which basically takes a XML file. So let us create a XML file and then add it in the onCreate method of the settings activity. So let me open the resource, right click new Android resource file, and you want XML resource file, and let me call it as user preference settings.xml and create the file. And if you observe right now, it is empty. It has something called as preference screen as the root tag. And you can just drag and drop the kind of settings that you want to maintain in this particular screen. Let me drag a edit text preference, which basically helps you to enter any kind of textual value. The default value can be, let's make it say unknown name. The key against which this value needs to be stored in the shared preference, display name key, and the title you want to give it as display name. So you can even categorize the settings. Let me create a group here and let me call it app settings, and inside the app settings I will add ringtone preference and checkbox preference and even switch preference. You can give any names to this. Let it be ringtone. The key is ringtone underscore preference one, and checkbox preference, let me give a name here, enable OTP read, and the title would be enable auto read OTP. And in the same way, the switch preference, let me call it as receive notifications, and title would be enable notifications. These are all just dummy settings. They don't mean anything until and unless it is actually backed up by some business logic. Now, what I have to do is, I have to inflate this in the settings activity. I will use something called as add preference from the resource r.xml user preference settings. And in the main activity, I am making use of a menu called as settings. And when you click on that, I am actually starting an activity, which is a settings activity. So let me run this. You click the menu and go to settings. It will launch another activity, and that is where you will see a screen which looks like typical settings of an application. Now the next logic is, as soon as I make any modifications in this particular screen, I need to be notified about it. For that, you have to basically create a class which implements the interface called as
OnSharedPreferenceChangeListener.
I am creating a class called as UserSettingsChangeListener. It implements an interface called as SharedPreferences.OnSharedPreferencesChangeListener, and this has got a method. You have to override that particular method. As soon as any changes happen in the shared preference, this method gets invoked. So let me write a toast here, toast.makeText, utilize the yum context, and then yes value change. So let me do a SharedPreference.getString and pass the key. If you want to have a default value, you can do that. Then show. Now I have a listener ready. I have to register this particular listener. Let me go back to the main activity. Let me create a listener instance variable, user settings listener. I have to register this particular listener when the settings activity gets launched. For that, let me go back to the start activity method here in the on options item menu selected. I will utilize preference manager dot get default shared preferences. I will pass the context object, and then I will register the listener. Before registering the listener, just make sure that the listener is initial. Listener is equal to new user settings listener, pass the context, and you pass that listener as the argument to the register on shared preference change listener. And also you have to make sure that you unregister the listener when the activity gets closed. So in the on destroy method or on stop method of the activity, you can just invoke unregister on shared preference change listener, pass the listener, and that's it. So let me rerun this application and let me give a new name. You can see the toast message because the callback method of the listener, which is basically on shared preference change, got invoked. So every time I change something here, a toast message comes. And this is how you work with the on shared preference change listener and the preference manager. There is of course more complicated scenarios and more complicated ways of designing preference activity, but basically the idea remains the same. With this, I end the discussion of the shared preferences. In the next video, I will come up with a new topic. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.